In this video, you're going to learn how to take a boring old screen recording and make it look 3D with animation using this free built-in effect in Premiere Pro. Let's get started. All right, so here is the sample video clip. It's just a static screen recording here from my new website that I started, learnpremiere.video. It's a free course that organizes all of my YouTube channel videos along with StoryCM's videos, so you can learn Premiere Pro from start to finish for free, so you can check that out. If you wanna download this demo clip, my patrons can download it for free as well as the final effect. The link is in the description. So the first thing you need to do is go up to effects and search for 3D. And you will find underneath perspective a basic 3D effect. So drag and drop this onto the clip here. Now what we're going to do is use the swivel and the tilt to emulate a computer screen. So the swivel parameter, this will rotate around the y-axis, and the tilt will rotate around the x-axis. So you can go ahead and play around with these until you get it in the right place. But remember, we're also going to control the position and the scale. So we can increase the scale, and we need to put this in the place to be our starting position for the animation. So for the swivel, I'm actually going to have it start the other direction. And let's go ahead and move this over and down until it looks best in frame, and then let's adjust the tilt as well. Probably not as much of a swivel in the beginning, maybe around -8. Let's change it to -7 tilt. And then we can adjust the position and the scale as well until it looks just right. All right, so let's say we want this to be our starting position. So what we're going to do is set a keyframe. To do that, just click on the toggle animation next to each parameter that we want to animate, which is the position, the scale, and the swivel, and the tilt. And also, we want to show the specular highlight. So what that's going to do is add a cool reflection when we start the animation. And by the way, welcome back to the Premiere Gal YouTube channel. My name is Kelsey, and if you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe, because according to my analytics, not a lot of you guys are subscribed. So hit that notification bell as well, so you're notified when I publish new videos. Also, this video is sponsored by Motiocan. Motiocan has the best graphics pack for Premiere Pro. If you leave a funny comment below, you'll be entered into a lottery to win a free license to this pack. It's available on Video Hive, literally in all of my videos. If you see those arrows, those cool glitch overlays, some cool transitions, everything is from that pack. There's also a free sampler pack. So if you're not yet sure if you want to get the full entire pack that has over 2,500 elements, you can download this free sampler pack that includes a few of the elements that you can test out. But my favorite parts of the pack are the kinetic titles, as well as the glitch overlays, and some cool interface icons as well, and some lower thirds. So if you're interested in trying out the pack, my affiliate link to the graphics pack is just down below. All right, let's go ahead and jump back into the video. So right now you're not gonna see anything happening with the specular highlight, which is the shiny part of the screen, because we haven't swiveled it in the right direction. So what we're gonna do now is go to the end position. So the part where we want this video to end up. So let's move the playhead to the end of the clip, and then we can choose to swivel it in a different direction. So we can swivel it this way, and look, now we see the specular highlight. And we can then adjust the position because we don't want the black up here. So to adjust that, let's go ahead and move this up and over, and maybe a little bit down, maybe not too far there. So then just go in and adjust the position and the scale until it looks right for your particular screen recording that you're working with. And I can adjust the tilt as well. And I think that looks okay. Let's adjust the position a little bit. And now you can see that these end keyframes were automatically created. We didn't have to manually create it because we already turned on the toggle animation here. So now between these two points, you can see what happens to the screen. So it has this nice swivel to it and the specular highlight, making it look more professional, like a 3D computer screen. But it's not done yet. The next thing we can do is add a Gaussian blur with a mask so we can emulate a lens focus changing from the upper left corner, for example, to the middle of the screen. So let's go back to effects and let's search for Gaussian blur. And let's go ahead and double click to apply it to our clip. Now back into effect controls, we can add a blurriness, let's say of around 12. And you can see it just applies the blur to the entire screen, which we don't want. To add a mask, just click on the circle icon and it will default to creating a mask. But we need to invert this. So let's click on inverted. And now the blurriness is outside of this ring. And let's make a few more adjustments. Let's increase the feathering so that way it's not as harsh of a line. And then we can adjust the shape. So let's go back to the beginning of the clip here. I want the focus to be up here on Learn Premiere. So let's go ahead and let's move this up here just like that. And let's, you know, make it a little bit smaller. I think that looks pretty good. And then we can create a keyframe on the mask path. So now that we have the keyframe, we can then move ahead a little bit. So let's select the mask path until we can get this little hand icon, and then we can move it over here in the center of the frame. And we can adjust this. If we want this to be faster, we can move this keyframe a little bit closer so it's a bit quicker of a rack focus there. And let's go ahead and play it back and see how it looks. All right. It can even be a little bit faster, so we can just move this in a little bit more. And this is how it looks. That's all for creating this really cool 3D screen effect. No template is needed. Just apply that 3D basic effect as well as the Gaussian blur and you're good to go. And thanks again for Motiocan for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to leave a funny comment below for a chance to win a license to their pack. If you do miss the lottery though, there is a free sampler pack below and you can purchase the pack from VideoHive on Envato Market. As always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye. It's so much harder now to reach you. Your heart is slow.